All right, guys, so this is my shop right now. I mean, I think I mentioned there were some pumpkins in here. You can see I've got two chairs. Sometimes I can actually sit down and work, but not today because the chairs are covered in pumpkins. Got a pumpkin in progress over there that we'll talk about in another video. Got some pumpkins hiding out in there. So it's going to be a little crowded today, but I will do my best to show you what's going on with the second half of this gorilla suit.
Is our foam core piece with the muscular chest cut out on it right there, right? A little crooked, but once it's glued in the suit, we just gotta make sure we put it in the suit straight. It doesn't matter that it's crooked on here. We've also got our liquid latex. Got some baby or talcum powder. I'll tell you what that's for in a minute. The top to a blender that doesn't need to be here at all. That's for the paper mache stuff. We have a slew of foam brushes. I had gotten this idea from a guy in another video that these foam brushes are great for the latex. I think actually they suck up a lot of the latex themselves, and they keep it from going where we want it to. But it's what I've been using, and I'm going to continue to use it today because it's what I've got hold of. I haven't tried the bristle brushes yet. We'll give those a shot. I've got an old food container, plastic container, that we're going to mix our latex in. And an old brush that I use the handle of for the mixing because, you know, like I've said, I'm cheap and I'm a recycler, so I like to use things as many times as possible. And when latex gets on these plastic handles, it peels right off, which I need to do or get in our black latex. All right, so the other thing I have, rubber dishwashing gloves. Make sure you wear hand protection. A rebreather. Because the fumes from this stuff, you want good ventilation, which I should probably have this plastic open. You want some good ventilation, and you want something to protect your breathing. And you guys are going to get to see me today in my fancy schmancy yellow goggles. So what we're going to do, we're going to put all my safety gear on. You won't be able to hear me once this is on as well, so let me give you a quick talk of what we're going to do. We're going to pour our liquid latex into our plastic container. Then we're going to squirt in a little bit of black paint, and we're going to mix that in until we get a color that's kind of grayish. Now, it's not going to be the black color that we want for the chest once we mix it, but what will happen is this liquid latex basically dries clear. So once the latex that we lay on here starts to turn black, we'll know that this is cured, and then, you know, we'll know it's basically dry, and we can put another coat on. So, when you see the proper color in your liquid latex, the color of your paint, that means you've got, you're dry enough to do another coat. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and shut you off for a second, so that I can put all my safety gear on, and I'll just show you quick what's going on, and then we'll talk about a little bit after I actually get some stuff on here.
We're going to take the baby powder, spread it around down here. This helps keep the latex from sticking to the plastic. I'm actually going to go with a closer to brown color for the chest, let it set out a little bit away from the black of the gorilla suit. If I decide I want to go darker, I always can, but you can't really go backwards as easily as you can go darker. So we'll start with the latex is probably the most expensive part of this. This stuff's like $60 a bottle. So I'm not going to start with a whole lot of it. Just in case I don't need it. I usually wind up with a lot left over. So you want to use a thing that you have a lid to, so you can cap it up in between and it doesn't dry out on you. For the time that you have it, it actually makes a pretty neat patching kit too. So any monster suit you have that has latex parts, you're going to want to bring the proper color latex with you to shoots and stuff in a small container, in case you need to patch anything up. So we got that in there. Take our old brush to mix it. So here we go. just kind of swirl it together like you're mixing, you know, ice cream or batter or anything like that. And you want to go and get as much of the paint in there as you can. Until you get a pretty consistent color in there. You see, there's still some swirls, but you get a pretty even color. There you go, get the bubbles out. Alright, and this bit that's stuck on here will wipe off onto the foam really nicely. Alright. So, I'll tilt you up a second. You can see where I'm painting better. I'm sorry everything's such a mess, guys. We're really in the middle of so many different projects right now. So, what I want to make sure you see me do, we want to get these edges of the foam core to be coated. Okay, right along this edge, that's the white paper showing, that's the white foam showing through and where the paper attaches to it. You want to get that coated up nice because that's going to be where our breakage will happen if it happens. And we don't want this breaking up too quickly again, you know. So go ahead and do that. As you can see it, this edge down here. So all four edges will do. And you get the idea. We're going to make sure we do all of those. Now we're going to cover this whole thing with as much latex as we can. And you may want to, once you start laying some on, powder your gloves. Because if your gloves are rubber or latex, they will stick to the latex you're working with. Alright? And I'll be back in a minute, guys, after I get some latex on here.
I took the breather off real quick just to show you. So this is it with latex mostly on the corners of the paper and on the chest. I kind of like how this looks with the black, the fleshiness against the black, but we are going to have to coat the whole thing. What we could do is go ahead and coat it with just clear latex, which will probably work. And so then this will be rubberized, but it'll keep its black color when the latex dries. It'll be a little bit hazier, but it'll be there. Or, you know, we can keep using the brown. The other thing I want to show you is make sure you do these sides. See, I missed a couple of sides here on the green. You want to get all that in and make it nice and thick on these sides here because eventually that's what's going to hold it to this. Once this is all latex, this stuff will be on here like crazy. I did the spongy stuff, the green foam, first because that stuff just sucks up the liquid latex. So it's going to go ahead and take it in right away. And if you look, if I should get a macro focus going here, if you look, you can see there's a texture there. That's up to you if you want to leave it. You're probably going to want to do at least two coats anyway, so you'll start to lose some of that. But if you do three or four coats, you'll cover it up pretty well. What you'll find is that the every coat you do, you'll need less latex to get it to go on there, and it'll spread a lot more thinly and stay because there won't be the sponginess left once this is all rubberized. And I should stop touching it with no gloves on. But so I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to use the brown over this black and see how it turns out. I think we'll still get some nice depth and raising from it, but I'm going to go real thin with it on this and nice and thick with it on the chest pieces and near the foam pieces we added on, because again, it'll act like its own kind of glue. And I used up a good half to two-thirds of what I mixed, so I'm going to need to mix quite a bit more. Although on top of this paper, it's going to spread a lot more thinly. And you can see here, there's already been some that dried on there, and you could see right through it. Like you could feel the tackiness to it, so you could start to do that too. Once you see it dry, kind of touch it with your bare hand when it's dry, when you suspect it's dry, and you'll still feel a little bit of tackiness there. That means you've rubberized it okay. It's just not as thick and colorful because it dries. This is, as opposed to the casting latex, dries really clear. So wherever the paint isn't mixed in, it's going to dry really clear. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and put my breather back on and be back in a couple of minutes. Hey guys, it's me. Sorry if you don't recognize me. My memory card filled up yesterday, and so what I did was I just stopped recording what we were doing, and went ahead and waited till today. And in between then, I kind of trimmed my hair, did a little bit of grooming on my beard, which made it darker. I don't know how that happened. It was just a coincidence. And my shirt grew sleeves and everything. So I've also got much classier safety goggles today instead of my blue blocker ones. I mean, I'm not working outside. I don't need the yellow. So we're back to the we're back to the gorilla chest. And you can see that the latex did two things. One I was not expecting, which was as it dried, it shrunk, and so it bent our foam core, which shouldn't be too big of a problem. Bend it back when we attach it in. I think I'm going to go ahead and leave it raised like this right now instead of putting the skin over it and keep the black around it. It's a little smudgy brown, so I don't know how much of that I'm going to leave. I'll peel this piece off right now. Although this will be inside, so it doesn't really matter. A lot of this surrounding area is going to be inside the fur. I'll come in here. You can see some spots are still green on the side there, so I'm going to have to get some in there. And then we still need to do the back, which I'm curious to see if latexing the back bends it back. And we're going to do that just for strength, really, latexing the back. Not so much for looks, because, of course, that'll be on the inside. And not a terribly whole lot for comfort, because, you know, latex right against your bare chest would be terrible. But you always want to be wearing a shirt under the gorilla suit. I find a turtleneck, a black turtleneck, come way up here, works really well. Or Zangone Studios, again, if you go to those guys, they sell a fur collar that goes here. So if you just wear a black shirt and then use the fur collar or a black turtleneck and attach the fur collar to that, it gives you a nice space between the head and the suit itself to bring them together. So sometimes when you'll move, the back of your mask will move up or the suit will ride down. And so from the back, the suits don't always play very well. But if you keep black in there, black on your sleeve, so if the sleeve rides up when you do a reach for anything, you know, I should probably just do a whole other thing on muster suits and what you should wear under them. I don't know if you noticed yesterday, I thought I had done the side, all the sides. And at one point, I had to go back and do this side again. And I thought it was just that it absorbed a bunch of the latex. And I thought I got away pretty clean. I didn't see any paint or latex on me. You remember, when I was putting it on, it looked kind of flesh-colored, which I was kind of happy about because I have a set of hands where the fingers are flesh-colored. But it dried brown, as we kind of expected it would. And that's going to help it stand out a bit more. I'm still not sure that's exactly what we want. What I'm probably going to do today is give it a quick coat, a real light coat of black spray paint, just to darken this color up like a hair. I don't want to go in and get actual paint on here. It's just kind of like a dusting of spray paint. We'll see how that works. And, you know, so like I said, when the latex is dry, it becomes the color of the paint. Well, I did get paint on me, and I'm going to show you that in a second. It's on my jeans, not in a great area. What had happened was, I leaned in on the side when I was turning this around, or on this corner here, but this corner seems, oh, no, there it is, it's missing right here. So I leaned in on this side here, and the latex from this transferred to my jeans, and now it looks like something took a poo on my jeans.
So look at that. I thought I had no paint on me, and I put these jeans on, and I go walking around, and then when the latex part dried, I got this brown stain goes right across very personal part of my jeans there. So, you know, be careful. You probably want to get a shop apron or, again, wear clothes that you don't mind getting dirty. These are not fantastic jeans. They got holes in the back. So there you go.
All right, so I'm going to go ahead and suit up and put some more latex and paint in the places it needs to go. This plastic back here that I told you to have open for ventilation yesterday, you still should have open for ventilation if you're using spray paint. I'm going to have it closed at this moment now because my very precious car is on the other side and I do not want any overspray settling on the paint of my car. If my black Jeep was in there, it would be kind of cool because the overspray would clean up the paint on that real nice because that paint needs a job. But so, going to patch up the green on these sides. I missed quite a few spots. And then I still have to do the back. And then I will come back and glue this into the suit. And if I can get my wife to run the camera, I will don the suit and show you how it looks in motion and stuff. I may need to add some hair to this area here to clean it up. We'll see how it plays on camera. All right. Thanks for watching, and we will be back in just a few clips with the finished product. So all we're going to do, all you're going to miss is me latexing the back, spray paint on the front, patching the areas I missed. Oh, and I'll show you right now, the areas where I did get the latex down correctly, you see how nice and snug that is on there. So these places that I missed, I definitely want to get some more down. And like I said, this liquid latex working, but casting latex would have been much better for this job. Fewer coats, and on these edges here, it would have held like, you know, it would hold it really, really strong. So next time, I would definitely be using casting latex. I had a little trouble getting it delivered in the amount of time I had. When you're shipping latex, if you're going to work with a lot of liquid latex and liquid casting latex, you want to order it in the spring, summer, fall, if you live in a place that has actual winter like North Carolina. When I lived in Florida, it didn't matter what time of year I ordered it, so I got a little bit lazy. But it can freeze in transit, and that'll separate the chemicals. It won't last as long. You want to make sure, if you get a big jug like this to save money like I do, every so often when you're in your workshop, give it a shake and get it going there. You should probably wear goggles when you do that in case the cap comes off, or at least check the cap's tight. But give it a shake so it doesn't separate out. And some people suggest storing it upside down sometimes. But you at least want to make sure you keep it mixed for as long as you have it. All right, so we're back in probably, you know, quite a little bit of time for us. 2-3 seconds for you, tops.
All right, we got another coat on that rubber there of the latex on the foam. Let me fill you in on a couple things you did miss while I had the camera turned off. This is truck bed coating. Fantastic for what we used it for the other day, which was making the pumpkin eater bumper for Jack versus Lanterns. I will tell you, this is Rust-Oleum brand. I usually use them because they're easier to find in spray form and at Home Depot and stuff. But fantastic for coating wood to make it look more like plastic or metal. I'll show you the bumper in another video and talk you through how we made it. It wasn't really a big production, and I had to do it very, very quickly because the bumper we had coming didn't arrive on time for the shoot, and we made some metal spikes for it. I'll show you all that stuff. I made the spikes so they can come on and off so we could drive with the bumper without having to worry about having fake spikes on it. And, you know, so this does have its uses, but painting a latex chest, not one of them. It dries as like a hard plastic. Would not have worked very well for this unless you want an inflexible chest, and it'd probably be fantastic. This is black spray paint. Now, this is cheap. I believe it's store brand from wherever I got it. It's like a buck a can. And the older it gets, the more that shows. The nozzle clogged up. Always test spray your can on something you don't care about before you spray it on something you worked on the day before. We wound up with a gorilla chest that looked like it had the measles. So there were black spots all over it instead of that nice dusting of paint I was going for. You know, because I always know what I'm doing. The interesting thing about this, it's less of a tutorial video and more of you joining me during my experiment. So I had to mix up some more brown latex to cover that mess up. As you can see, it's dry and blotchy now. I took the opportunity to add some nipples to our ape chest because, you know, realistically, he'd have some. What I did was I just rolled up a piece of shop towel into a wad, dropped it in a little pool of latex that I made around each one where I wanted to put them. That should hold it in place, and then I put latex over the paper towel in the shop towel. Once that absorbs it, it should make a nice little piece that'll stay there for good. And I put it on with a tool I'd forgotten about. Remember I was saying the foam brushes have a tendency to suck up some of your latex and waste it on you. And again, that stuff's, you know, between $40 and $60 a gallon. So if you're cheap like me, you want to try and save some. This, see, some of it's still stuck to it as it dried, but it doesn't absorb any of your latex on you. So this or a plastic plaster spatula, plaster spreader, both will work really fine, especially when you're putting it on something foam like this that's going to grab it for you. And the nice thing is once this dries, I'll be able to peel off the color that I used already and put on a new one. So, you know, and use it for the next time. So you can get a lot of uses out of this cheap little supposedly one-use plastic thing. And you just spread it on like butter or peanut butter. Just goes right across. It's fantastic. I come with sound effects and everything. So, yeah. So, got to wait for that to dry to do the back now. And then we'll put it in. So the same thing, we'll be back in a couple of minutes. But thanks for joining me for this experiment in gorilla chess making. I had this upside down on the table so that the back wouldn't get stuck to the table. And because of that, these little extra pieces that I added, they were bowed up, so they didn't stick to the table, which is great. But, you know, because remember, this bowed a bit when it shrunk, and it's gone back a little bit now that the back's done, and it's pulling it back. But it's actually bowing the other way now, you can see, which is cool. But since they didn't dry, I can't glue them into the fur just yet without risking getting latex stuck in the fur. And so I went ahead and patched up some more places that I wanted and did some more coverage, because those will all dry faster than these thick pieces I did to hold the little paper towel nipples in place. So I will get this up on Saturday for you, but I should have come down. I knew the back would dry pretty quickly, like probably in an hour, because it was a very thin coat, and I should have come down and turned it back over and exposed these to the air more to make sure they'd be ready for this morning, because those thicker sections I should have thought would take much longer to dry. I got to run to my other job right now. I will get back to this as soon as I get back. Thanks for sticking around, guys. Bye-bye.
So, this is it, guys. The new chest. Brown. So you can see the hands I generally use when he's a monster ape are chimp hands from Zango Studios. Believe it or not, they did not sponsor this video. I just love their stuff, so I keep buying stuff. The suit has, I left the corners in on that foam board, and it's kind of spread out here. As long as I can get my arms in the sleeves and move around relatively well, I think I'm going to leave it, because it gives him this nice broad-chested ape kind of look to it. And pieces of the old chest are falling off when I beat it, but if this is staying in place, I think we're good. I don't want to beat on it too much, so I get some more glue under there. I'm afraid it's going to fall right down. I've also, like I said before, right now the back's just tied, but I have a hump that goes back here. I'll probably show you guys sometime. That'll set off the size of this really nicely, because the hump widens out my suit. So there you go, ape chest. About $3 worth of leftover stuff. I mean, if you make it new, it might cost you $20-$30. Depending on how much latex you buy. If you buy the full gallon, it's going to cost you a lot more, but a pint certainly would have gotten me through on this one. And to fix a $100 suit that I've had for 10 years and keep it running for a couple more movies, I think that's pretty good. I mean, we got to shoot, my wife's going to make a face because I said no more movies this year, but we do have a short, it's a little short movie, it's part of another movie, that we got to shoot this coming spring, and I need my ape suit to work. So there you go. Back to Jack versus Lantern stuff with the next episode. And let me know if you'd like to see some stuff down in the comments about, you know, what I carry on shoots, what kind of lights I use, how to get cheap lights at the hardware store, what's in my power pack, what kind of tripods I like, what kind of tripods I hate, what kind of stands you should absolutely have, types of tape, things like that. And let me know if you're interested in any of that stuff. And please subscribe. The link might be here. It might be here. I don't know what I'm doing. So, you know, check out other channels. Check out our webpage. And we'll be back soon. Thanks a lot.